Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1519. Record, fill down. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, you know, one of my favorite features is to double click the fill handle to copy a formula. But that, if you turn on the macro recorder and try and record that action, it does not work. All right, so let's record a macro here, and we'll just call this TryOne. Shortcut key of Ctrl+Shift+A, stored in this workbook. All right, so here's what the macro does. First, we go to View, Macros, Use Relative References. Come over here, New Head, go down one, enter a formula. I don't care what the formula is, this divided by that. And then double click the fill handle. All right, so we have our macro. We want to stop recording. So View, Macros, stop recording. All right, now what's interesting is if we try this macro on the exact same data set, Ctrl+Shift+A, it works great. The problem is when we have more records like this, they didn't actually record, Ctrl+Shift+A, the action of double clicking the fill handle. It only recorded copying down to however many records we had in the first day. So this is completely useless. But I figured there had to be some way that we could use the macro recorder to solve this problem. So let's try this second approach, macros. Record macro, I'll call it TryTwo, Ctrl+Shift+S, click OK. Now, first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to turn off the relative reference initially, because there's two cells I know that I want to deal with. I want to deal with this new heading here, and I want to deal with my formula, equal this divided by that. All right, so that's interesting. I always know that the first place for the formula is going to be in cell F2 every single time. All right, now from here I'll go back to A1. At this point, that's when I turn on relative reference. All right, now watch these steps. Control down arrow to get me to the last row. Control right arrow to get me to the last column. One more right arrow to get me to the bottom of the column where I want to copy things. Then from here, Ctrl+Shift+Up arrow. Now this is really cool. So now I've selected that first formula that I entered in the macro, plus all of the blank cells all of the way down. Now, I talk about the double click the fill handle trick all the time, but there's another trick that would work right here. It's called Ctrl+D, which is the shortcut for fill down. Watch this, Ctrl+D. All right, so it fills everything down. Now, that is a lot more hassle than double clicking the fill handle, admittedly. But the huge advantage is when we record the macro in that way, I'll stop recording and come out here with more records. Let's put more records in. And do Ctrl+Shift+S. Bam, it works no matter how many records there are. Even if there's less records, let's try that. Ctrl+Shift+S. It still works every time. All right, so if you're trying to record a macro and use that fill down feature, it is possible, but you have to kind of in absolute mode enter the heading, enter the first formula, and then use in relative mode control down arrow, control right arrow to get over there, and then control shift up arrow to select all the blank cells plus the heading, and then from there, Ctrl+D. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. By the way, for VBA, if you want to get beyond the macro recorder, my book here, VBA and Macros from Microsoft Excel 2010. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.